Revolutionary greetings, fellow Africans, revolutionary salutations, Zimbabweans, and the world compatriots. My name is Comrade Gift Ostallos Siziba. I'm the General Secretary of the MTC Youth Assembly under the capable stewardship of President Advocate Nelson Chamisa. It's been 6 months under Dambudzo's House of Terror, where I've been arrested for inciting public violence at a rally where I dressed here in the capital in Harare. Just a few hours ago, I was released by the court so that the state continues on someone for a simple reason that the state is no witness. And today, fellow Africans, fellow Zimbabwe, we are celebrating International Human Rights Day. It is sad, it is a disgust, it is a disappointment that we as young people continue to exist in a society that is thwarting and suppressing democratic space. As a generation, we face a number of challenges. Just a few years ago, I was detained in Chikurubi maximum prison for the same concocted charges of exercising that which is within the confines of our constitution, which is freedom to demonstrate and freedom to speak our mind. Fellow compatriots, this is the challenge. This is what we see, this is what inhibit in the so-called new dispensation. Fellow Africans, fellow Zimbabweans, world compatriots, this is a clear sign that there is nothing new in the so-called new dispensation. And as young people, as a generation, we remain committed to the fight for a democratic developmental state anchored on a socially just economy. As we celebrate Human Rights Day, we call for the state, we call for the region, we call for the international community to look into the Zimbabwean's case insofar as the human rights discourse is concerned. Because without the right to speak as a people, as a generation, we feel that the state is stealing so much from us. Because what makes the difference between myself and the dog is the ability to speak. It is coherent articulation of issues through the beauty of language. And when we speak and we are suppressed as a people, when we are arrested, when we are detained, when we are tortured for speaking our mind, we believe that we have been robbed so much as a people, as a generation. Why do we do this? The fight for democracy in this country, we are committed to it as a generation because we want to live a life better than the dogs of the rich. We want the future of our children to be better. Most of us have a blessing of waking up in an empty stomach and a jobless existence. When we speak demanding jobs, when we speak demanding health care, when we speak demanding freedom in our country, we are not becoming terrorists, we are not becoming rebels, but we are young people exercising that which is in the constitution, which is the supreme law of the land. And we wish and we are committed to stay in this course so that we see the establishment of democracy in our lifetime. And we want to state it categorically clear here and now that we're going to continue this path, we're going to continue this fight until we see a democracy in Zimbabwe. I thank you.